Hey, welcome back. Those of you watching us from all over the world, we welcome you, whether you're watching us in India or Europe. We're so glad that you're there on portable TV or on your regular TV channel. On this day, the United States is accusing China of creating a pandemic, maybe on purpose. On this day, the United States and China have warships that are facing each other in the South China Sea. On this day, bombs are still going off in Afghanistan in a war that we began decades ago. On this day, our State Department is having to explain for what appears to be another aborted coup in Venezuela. On this day, the United States and France are arguing about who will keep the money rights to an eventual vaccine for COVID-19. Wouldn't you think that with the entire world in peril right now, given this COVID-19 coronavirus situation, that we would somehow find a way to put our differences aside? To address this issue, we are joined by the legendary Pink Floyd founder, Roger Waters, lyricist, composer, all-around big thinker. Good enough to join us now. What is it about us, Roger? Is it something about us as human beings, or is it the politics and the governments that we're led by that just can't seem to be able to get their act together, even in times like this?
Yeah, it is. You know, I've got the elephant in the room behind me over my shoulder. You can see him there. And the elephant in the room, sadly, is neoliberal economics. Mm. I believe that to be the truth. You know, clearly, what COVID-19 has told us all is that in order to face a common enemy like a virulent virus like this, we are going to need to have to cooperate, to act together, to act cohesively as a community, a global community, in order to defeat the common enemy. This is extremely difficult when we are driven, a lot of us anyway in the Western world, by a motive which is to maximize the bottom line of profit for the corporations that run our countries. That's what the elephant is telling me. If we don't cooperate, we're all dead. The planet's over. We're heading for the cliff of omnicidal destruction of everything. So will this be a wake-up call? I hope so. I'm so glad that you're having these conversations with people on RT, on your TV show.
We try to do this because sometimes it seems like you're, you know, pushing against the wind, and you can't move anything. And you wonder, how do we do that, Roger? How do we get people together to stop thinking about just getting through their day and thinking about what the days are gonna be like for the generations we leave after us?
We refuse to shut up. We refuse to be quiet. We continue to rebel. We say, no, this is bullshit. This is just not good enough. We do not want to go back to that normal. What was that normal? Hey, what do we do today? I know, let's print trillions of dollars and give it away to rich people. What a good idea, said the bankers, and that's what they did. And then COVID-19 came along, and they went, what are we gonna do in the face of this new terrible pandemic that is facing the human race? Brilliant idea, let's print billions, trillions of dollars and give it away to very, very rich people. What? So what's changed? Nothing. Still no real cooperation between, you know, people in this community in North America, where I live. Mm-hmm. There's probably a lot more cooperation between people in China because they at least have a health service and they have a social system. Whether you agree with the rest of their politics or not is neither here nor there. But the whole new Chinagate thing could not be more destructive than it is, and all this nonsense with Pompeo going back to Venezuela with his pitiful little attempts to remove Maduro is so destructive of any possibility that we might move forward. You know, the Venezuelans are trying to help, as are the Cubans and many others, to face this really serious medical problem. Sorry, I interrupted you.
No, I was just thinking as I was listening to you talk, because I think you're saying things that make a lot of sense, Roger, and unfortunately, you're a lone voice in the wilderness. Our media, our government leaders, our business leaders, the people that for traditionally, at least, we depended on to help us, they're not there for reasons that sometimes we can't understand. So what are we left with? Who do we follow? How do we create the exigence to find some kind of commonality and find some kind of answer to these things that you're bringing before us?
Well, luckily, without the constraints of the mainstream media, there is a community on the internet of people who are interested in the truth, who are interested in human rights, who are interested in democracy, who are interested in liberty, who are interested in curing people, who are interested in paying the nurses and the cab drivers and the lorry drivers and all the essential workers all over the world a living wage, who are interested in those things. And we do communicate one with the other. And the main focal point of our conversation often is, how do we combat the huge propaganda machine that has persuaded most of our brothers and sisters that this is normal and that it's okay for there to be Jeff Bezos and Mark Zuckerberg and a couple of other people, and everybody else is on the breadline. At the end of every month or the first of every month, we're all scratching in our pockets trying to figure out, how can we make this add up? They don't pay us enough to pay rent. We're living in and I think that is part of the technique. But the propaganda that we're faced with every day is, don't worry about that. Just leave it to us, the leaders. Leave it to your leaders. We'll figure it out. What's important is that we have a war with the Chinese or the Russians or the Iranians or the Venezuelans or the Nicaraguans or whoever it might be. Because that's the propaganda that
conflict.
They sell, sadly.
But yeah,
we
conflict.
Are many.
Yeah.
We are many. There are many, many, many of us now. And people are slowly waking up. It's a slow process all over the world. Ping, ping, ping.
Roger Waters. Wow. You're a thinker. I thought you were. You are. You proved it. And it's been an honor and a pleasure to have you on to share these ideas. I hope to be able to get you back, my friend.
I'll come back anytime, man. Thank you so much. Appreciate it.
Thank you, Roger.